My theory is, like, if somebody has an idea, whether it's you, me, or the band members, let's try it. Because it's always easier to try it, faster to try it than argue about why it won't work.
Such a great point.
But it seems like every time we got ideas, try it. It was usually the one that needed to go on the record.
Pretty much had utilized, like, all the band members on all the tracks, except for October 1st, which is more stripped back. But yeah, some are quite delicate, and they were just so tasteful in figuring out how to contribute.
Yeah, their sensibilities of what to play and what not to play is equally important. I remember Danny, the legendary Danny Dugmore, was such an important part of this. It was the only song that I was probably overloading with parts right before lunch. Danny came up to me at lunch. He goes, "You know, it was probably be better before," but however he worded it, but he was very gentle. He goes, "You know, you might want to listen to that first pass of that without all the extra, you know, parts and busyness." And he was so right. And that's the one we used on the record. So,
but I didn't even know if I caught that.
It was
so
subtle,
cool.
You know, instead of yelling it across the room.
And, right. Brian Sutton just contributed so much. I loved my favorite moment that Brian did was when he was like, "Y'all pull out the bouzouki."
Yeah.
Or "Y'all pull out the bouzouki and the banjo." And loving so much acoustic music, instrumental music and stuff that I grew up doing. That was a huge, we would have missed so much if we wouldn't have had the different things that he brought. I think he was the first person that you were like, if we can get Brian Sutton, like, we have to get Brian Sutton. he was one of the first people that you mentioned to me.
Yeah.
Mark Hill did such cool stuff. I always think bass, it always just has such a cool role in music, because it's like, if it's not there, you miss it. And it's kind of unassuming, but like makes everything so much cooler. We were starting on Slow Me Down. That's the oldest song. That's a song that I did with my family. One of the only ones that I was coming back and doing again. And Sweet Gordon, he's just sitting there, and then he just starts simplest little da da da
da da da.
It was just like, we have to do that. Like, now I can't hear that song and not hear that. Like, a different version of that was on Gone. I'm hearing it a certain way in my head, and Fred is such a great drummer, and he was doing all sorts of cool fun stuff and kind of locked into a beat, and we were playing with it, and we were like, maybe that's not it. And immediately was like, what about this? What about this? And it was like, oh, that. And everybody like, knew when we got it.
Let's try out.
He's so unique and earthy the way he approaches things, and
I like that. Yeah,
and it's not just conventional drum beats. It's he may be playing something he found in his kitchen or using his hands instead of sticks. And
to your credit, that we even had drums, because remember I was like, I don't know if we should have drums, and you were like, well, I swear this guy's really good. We'll get it.
I couldn't be any more prouder than I am of the way the record turned out. And we've had such a good working relationship too. I mean, you may be the most prepared artist I've ever worked with. I mean,
really,
in the best ways. I mean, when it came to vocal days or, you know, violin overdubs, you knew what your parts were. You were ready. You had lyric sheets.
What's your favorite song on the record?
Boy, that's hard to say.
Choose your favorite child. That's what it feels like.
I like River Runaway a whole bunch. Yeah. Gone is pretty great. I just played you that. And that's pretty.